What's up guys, I'm Rupak and in this video I'm going to show you how you can make a drone using Arduino and HC12 transceiver module. And I swear we'll not use any sort of expensive transmitters or flight controllers to make this project. Now because we'll use HC12 module, that means we also need to make our own transmitter to control the drone. Don't worry, it's not difficult at all. I'll try to cover all the small details in this video so that we are able to make the drone successfully. You can find all the Arduino codes, schematics, any documentations in my GitHub repository and the link is in the description box. So let's begin by listing all the parts that you need to build your own transmitter. To build a transmitter, you'll need two joysticks, one Arduino board, preferably Arduino Nano or Pro Mini because we are going to solder everything. Then you need a HC12 transceiver module. One last thing which is completely optional is an OLED display. I used it to visualize the position of joysticks, but you can skip it without any issues. Later in the video, I'll also talk about some safety features that I added to the Arduino code, like connection break protection and emergency stopping. You can now see the schematic of the transmitter on your screen, and basically you just have to wire everything as shown. You can find the schematic inside the documentation directory on GitHub. I would recommend you to solder everything on a prototyping board or just get a PCB printed. I went for the latter option, but because it was my first time designing a PCB digitally, I made a few mistakes and I had to correct them manually. The most major mistake was that the button on the right joystick came out non-functional, but I didn't bother to correct it as we are not going to use any buttons to control the drone. This also means that you can completely skip the wiring of the buttons to the Arduino if you want to. Now I'm using the default settings for HC12, so you do not need to configure it using AT commands. Don't worry if you're not familiar with AT commands. This information is for the users who want to use custom HC12 settings, and for that I've also provided the Arduino code on GitHub. Now you have to upload the transmitter code to the Arduino board, but before that you'll need to install Neo SW Serial Library, which is being used in the code for transmitter and the drone. To install the library, you just have to go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries, and then search for Neo SW Serial and click Install. Now you are ready to upload the transmitter code to your Arduino board. The code is inside a directory called Transmitter. Finally, you have completed making your own transmitter. Now it's time to check if everything is working as expected. To test the transmitter, get another Arduino board and another HC12 module. Wire them as shown here and upload the Arduino code inside the receiver directory. This code is just to check your transmitter. This is not the actual drone code. Feel free to use this code as a template to create other projects using the same transmitter. After uploading the code, open the serial monitor and turn on your transmitter. You should see the values of the joysticks and buttons getting printed on the serial monitor. You can also perform a range test with the same setup. If everything is working as shown, then you are ready to build the drone. Okay, to build a drone, you'll need a drone or a quadcopter frame, 4 brushless DC motors and propellers. I'm using 1000 kV motors, that means for each voltage drop, the motor increases the speed by 1000 RPM. Now you need 4 electronic speed controllers or ESCs. I'm using 30 amp ESCs. Next, you need one Arduino board, again preferably Arduino Nano or Pro Mini because we are going to solder everything. Then you need one HC12 module, 3 cell lithium polymer battery, and finally MPU6050 module, which is a combined accelerometer and gyroscope module. At this point, you can start assembling your drone frame. You can also connect your motors to the ESCs. The clip which you are seeing right now was recorded when I was testing the drone, and during the course of testing I even broke one propeller. I made this project long time back but did not get the time to make a tutorial video. Moving forward, now you have to wire everything as shown. Make sure that the ESCs are turned off and only the Arduino board is switched on. If you don't know how to wire a brushless motor to the ESC, then for now just connect any 3 wires of the motor to any 3 wires of the ESC and don't worry about the spin direction. You can change it later. Now you have to upload the ESC calibrate code to your Arduino. After uploading the code, the built-in LED will turn on for 10 seconds and then go off, and within these 10 seconds you have to turn on your ESCs. This will calibrate your ESCs. The ESC make a specific sound or a specific tone when it gets calibrated. Now you have to upload the EEP ROM clear code to your drone's Arduino board. You can find the code in File, Examples, EEP ROM, EEP ROM clear. After the built-in LED starts glowing, you have to upload the multi-V code to your Arduino board. I modified the original multi-V code so that it can receive signals from HC12 module. And this is the actual flight controller code. Now you have to set up everything as shown in the schematic, and here is an important note that you need to take care about. While testing, I was using normal length jumper cables to connect MPU6050 with the Arduino board, and because of that I was getting large errors while estimating the drone's orientation. The Arduino used to freeze occasionally, then I had to switch to small jumper cables and it started working smoothly. So I would recommend you to solder everything on a prototyping board and try to keep MPU6050 as close to the Arduino board as possible. At this point, don't worry about the motor spin direction. We'll fix it while configuring the drone's parameters. Now go to the multi-V config directory and you'll see the multiple folders. If you are a Mac user, then you should open the applications.macOSX folder and run the config application. But for some reason it didn't work for me, so I had to switch to my dad's Windows PC for this step. If you are a Windows user, then you should open application.windows32 even if you are using 60-bit version of Windows. You need to install Java for this step. Now connect your Arduino to the PC and open the application. Select the COM port, click the start button and select read. At this point you should be able to see the visualization of the drone's position. Now keep the drone on a flat surface and click Calib ACC button. Leave the drone untouched for about 10 seconds. Now select either angle mode or horizon mode when the aux to button is low. Also set the pitch and roll rate to anywhere between 0.25 and 0.5. And click the write button. Now also click the read button to make sure that all the settings have been transferred to the Arduino. Get your transmitter and power on the ESCs. Make sure that the propellers are not attached and move the left joysticks towards the right for about 3 seconds. At this point, all the motors should spin. Make sure that the motors spin in the direction as shown. If any motor doesn't spin in the right direction, then just switch any two cables of the motor and the ESC. Now let's move on to the controls. Moving the left joystick up and down controls the throttle or the altitude of the drone. Moving the left joystick to the left and right controls the yaw or the rotation of the drone. The right joystick handles pitch and roll or forward, backward, left and right motion in other words. Moving the left joystick to the right for 3 seconds at minimum throttle arms the drone, and moving the left joystick to the left for 3 seconds at minimum throttle disarms the drone. Now let's take a look at some emergency features. Moving both joysticks to the outwards and down stops the drone immediately. If the drone disconnects while flying, then the built-in LED on the drone and as well as the transmitter starts glowing, and the drone starts to descend until it regains the signal. If the drone never regains the signal, then it makes a safe landing. Now you are ready to attach the propellers. Make sure that the propellers push the air downwards, and now you are ready to fly. I tried to include everything in this video, but still if I missed out something, I'll update it on GitHub and in the description box. With this, we come to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you around.